Last time we have seen visually echoic potentials. Today we are going to discuss about artery evoked potentials. These are all electrical potentials evoked in the brain. Nutshell, they are called as brainstem evoked potentials. So for today, auditory we are going to see. This is how the electrode supplied in the occipital region, the lateral canthus, and on the mid zone here. Therefore, this is the position of the electrodes, and we record the waves. We record the waves of the electrodes. How the wave pattern is there? What are the normal waves? What are the abnormal waves? And based on that information, we try to come to a diagnosis. There are different type of wave patterns, and the variations from normal. We come to a conclusion about the diagnosis. They help only in diagnosis. Only with other diagnostic procedures, with collaboration with other diagnostic procedures, and this also added up to the diagnosis. Singly, we cannot base upon this. We have to take all other considerations also, and then we have to come to a conclusion. Here, then. Yeah, today we are dealing with the brainstem artery evoked potentials. That was the what I have shown the figure. That was about the visual. These electrodes were placed in the occipital region here. This is the brainstem evoked potential. This is the potentials recorded from the artery pathway. Artery pathway which starts from the hair cells. From the hair cells, eighth cranial nerve division, and from there it goes to the primary artery cortex in the cerebral cortex, artery area in the cerebral cortex. Therefore, in this pathway, right, starting from the eighth cranial nerve, cochlear division of vestibular cochlear nerve, eighth cranial nerve. We are dealing with the cochlear division of the eighth cranial nerve. From there to the primary artery cortex in the cerebral cortex. Therefore, in the area number 41, 42, that's the pathway. In this path, whatever the potentials are recorded, we will be recording like this. There are these wave patterns 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Like this, the wave patterns are there, and we have a normal wave pattern. What is normal? We know what is normal. Just like ECG, we know what is normal. And any abnormal deviation from the normal, we take it as a abnormal. Here also we have got the wave patterns. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, I have not shown. Like this, there are number of wave patterns. And this is the duration of response in milliseconds. We have the early response, mid response, and late response. Late response, more than 10 seconds. Early response, less than 10 seconds. All these things we'll be dealing. And we have got the negative waves. And the positive waves and negative waves we have got. Therefore, these are potentials recorded in the artery pathway, starting from the cochlear division of the eighth cranial nerve to the cerebral cortex. This, whatever the electrical potentials are there, here brainstem artery evoked potential, brainstem artery evoked potential stimuli here, BAEPS. Yeah, the stimulus travels right from the cochlea. That is, you have got the two rows of hair cells, and the ends of the hair cells, the axons of these hair cells, they form the cochlear division of the eighth cranial nerve, and they travel upwards. Stimulus travels, therefore we are saying the stimulus travels from the cochlear division of the eighth cranial nerve, starting from the starting point to higher up. It generates potential in all the nerve fibers. All the nerve fibers that are ascending from the the occlusion of the eighth granula starting from the cochlea. Therefore, from there to the higher observable cortex, it generates action potential AP in all the nerve fibers. These are the response. Brainstem artery evoked a response. Whatever response we get, brainstem artery evoked a response. This response we get from the potential. We get this response, brainstem artery evoked response from the potentials. They assess the status of the artery pathway up to the midbrain. Suppose there is this is the functional status of the pathway. Suppose that there is any pathology, that is any disturbance in the pathway, and there will be a change in the response. Brainstem artery evoked response changes will be there. The waveforms are named, as I have already told you, the waveforms are named. The brainstem artery evoked potentials waveforms. We have different type of waveforms. They are given the Roman letters 1 to 7. The different waveforms. And we know the normal pattern of each waveforms. Yeah. Often these two, we may not be able to see 2 and 4 also. And 4 and 5 may be indistinguishable. There may be merged. Therefore, 2 and 4 may not be visible in all the pictures, in all the recordings. These two forms may not be visible. Therefore, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, and we know the normal pattern. And here's the nutshell, the artery pathway. Already you know the artery pathway. Therefore, we have already discussed in our charts also artery pathway. Here, artery now. Artery now from the cochlear division of the eighth cranial nerve. Emerging from the hair cells which are in two rows. In two rows we have got the hair cells. And the cochlear division of eighth cranial nerve is emerging from it. And from here, they are traveling to the dorsal and mantle nuclei. Some fibers are going directly upwards and some fibers are going to the, crossing to the opposite side. And then they go to the superior olivary nucleus. And then from there to the lateral lemniscus. And from the lateral lemniscus, the inferior colliculus midbrain area, medial gentler body. And from there to the primary artery cortex. Here, the pathway, we have already discussed in our charts, the pathway. The pathway is going, cochlear division of the eighth cranial nerve is going, and it is joining the dorsal and ventral nucleus, and they cross, that is, some may go directly, then they go to the superior olivary nucleus, and from there to the lateral lemniscus, and from there to the inferior colliculus, and from there to the primary artery area. And this is the pathway. Suppose now we are evoking potentials from these areas. Brainstem evoked potentials are arising when we are giving some stimulus. When we are giving a stimulus from this root, potentials, all the nerve fibers in this root, they start giving a brainstem artery evoked response. Therefore, when we are sending some stimulus, electrical stimulus, something, potentials, these all the nerve fibers in this root, they get stimulated and they record in the waveforms. Just now I told you 1 to 7 waveforms. Therefore, they are recorded in the waveforms. Therefore, any damage in this area, suppose any abnormality in these areas, any abnormality in these areas, we come to know that something is wrong with the central artery pathway, because the waveform that is we are getting in the response, that is brainstem artery response, whatever we are getting, it is not normal, it is deviating from the normal. Hence we have a rough idea that something is wrong in the artery path. In this way, this helps the in coming to a conclusion that everything is not okay. Yeah. I told you that the waveforms are the different waveforms, seven type of waveforms. The first wave, origin of wave one, it is to the peripheral part of the cochlear division of the eighth cranial nerve. It is arising, whatever waveform we are getting in the wave one, it is from the peripheral region of the cochlear division of the eighth cranial nerve. That is from the, it is from the cochlea. Here. The peripheral division of the cochlear nerve, and this wave two is from the pons. Wave two, and we got the wave three from superior olivary complex, midbrain. Wave four from the lateral lemniscus. Wave five from the inferior cochlea. That is wave one from the peripheral part of the cochlear division, and wave two from here. Three superior olivary complex, lateral lemniscus, five. Here, wave one. Peripheral portion of the eighth cranial nerve adjacent to the cochlea. Just now we have seen in the figure. First response is from here. The first response is from peripheral portion of the cranial nerve, eighth cranial nerve, that is cochlear division. It is adjacent to the cochlea, that is the lowermost part, first part. The wave comes from there. From the potential, which is action potential, which is arising out of the stimulus, whatever wave we are getting in response, that is from this area. This gate represents the volume conducted electrical activity. It represents electrical activity from the that region of the auditory nerve. It represents electrical activity from that region. Volume conducted electrical activity from that region. We have got this wave height and all we can measure. Then wave two. Wave two is from the cochlear nucleus. It is from the pons. It is actually from the cochlear nucleus. It is from the pons. Wave three. Wave three is from the midbrain. Wave from the peripheral part of the cochlea adjacent to the cochlea. Two from the pons. Three from the midbrain, superior olivary nucleus. This generates wave three. Whatever wave is get response, we are getting. That is response seen in wave three is from this area, from the midbrain, superior olivary nucleus. Therefore, from each area we have got. The first wave was from the cochlear division of eighth cranial nerve near the peripheral portion peripheral portion of the eighth cranial nerve adjacent to cochlea. Second is from the pons. Electrical activity, whatever it has been recorded, pons. Three is from the midbrain, superior olivary nucleus. And four is from action potential from lateral lemniscus. Therefore, whatever we see in the wave four, it is arising from the lateral lemniscus. And wave five from the inferior cochlea. Therefore, wave five is from inferior. Therefore, each wave is from a different region. Therefore, we say if you see an abnormality in wave five, suppose here, that is the electrical action potential arising from a inferior cochlea is not normal. We have to come to a conclusion there. And depending upon the response, we have divided it into three latency periods. Short, mid, and long latency period, depending upon the response. The short latency period is less than 10 milliseconds. The response, suppose we are giving a stimuli. We are giving a stimuli. The response we get, this brainstem artery evoked response, whatever we get. That is the wave. The wave seen here is about less than 10 milliseconds. Mid is from 10 to 100 milliseconds. The response is seen in 10 to 100 milliseconds. And the long response is from 100 to more than 100 milliseconds. Therefore, we got three types of responses. Short, less than 10 milliseconds, mid 10 to 100, and more than 100. Early, as we already seen, it is a less than 10 millisecond response, and this is called as brainstem artery evoked potential. And we have got another thing, interpeak latency response. Interpeak latency response. Yeah, in between these two peaks, there's some time gap is there. Interpeak latency. Let's say interpeak latency. It has gone to peak. Again, it has gone up. And in between, there's a downfall. Yeah, interpeak latency response. There's a response is slow down here. Again, it is going up. This reflects neural conduction. It reflects the conduction in the corresponding segments. That is the conduction from here, the first response from the cochlear division of the eighth cranial nerve, peripheral part, to pons. Cochlear division of eighth cranial nerve to pons. And in between, there's a fall. Therefore, indirectly we can take into conclusion, it is a conduction, neural conduction. Reflects the time taken for the neural conduction in the corresponding segments. It's a conduction period. It is taking from here to here. It is called interpeak latency response. Mid latency will. Early latency is less than 10 milliseconds. Mid latency response, 10 to 50, we have said it's almost 10 to 100, I said. Almost 10 to 100. It is written as 50, but it's like 10 to 100. It is considered to represent the electrical activity arising in the thalamic articularizations, the primary artery cortex, and early association areas and centers. Therefore, response whatever we are getting is this from these areas. Thalamocortical radiations, connections between thalamus and cerebral cortex, primary artery cortex in the cerebral cortex, and the association areas, the areas which are associated with hearing. The response of the mid latency phase is from all these areas. From the thalamocortical radiation connections, primary artery cortex, and the areas which are helping in the primary artery cortex. From there, therefore, mid latency phase is the response arising from these areas. Now, coming to late latency phase. Late latency phase is characterized by more than 100 milliseconds. First classification has given them more than 100 milliseconds here all. There and here also it is written 50, correct it as 100. Characterized by latency of more than 50 milliseconds. Therefore, it has a large negative N1 wave and a large positive P2 wave. Late latency phase as a large negative wave and large positive wave. Now, brainstem artery evoked potential clinically useful in diagnosing hearing loss in infants and small children. In infants and small children, they may not be able to express the hearing loss. And it is very difficult for us to also assess the hearing loss. If it is a complete hearing loss, if we clap or something, the child may not be seeing, turning his head. But if it's a partial hearing loss, we may not be able to identify. So Suppose complete hearing loss, the child will not respond even to the any type of sound. Therefore, we may diagnose, because child will not be turning his head or something like that. We will be saying that something is wrong with the child. But a partial loss means these are useful as hearing loss in infants and small children, and to assess them how much, whether it is a grossly this thing or something, we can to some extent a degree of this thing. Other investigations also there, they also help in assessing the correct, useful in correct assessment of the child. Therefore, the electrodes are placed here. The child is assessed for hearing loss. Another usefulness of this brainstem artery potentials are use on locating the brainstem lesions. If there are any brainstem lesions, these potentials may not be normal. They may differ. And then diagnosing the tumors, the various levels. We have seen so many levels. We have seen the dorsolateral ventral nucleus and all these things we have seen. Lateral lemniscus we have seen. All these things we have seen. And the tumors of various levels, at a various levels, if there are any tumors growth, it may be helpful to diagnose, because the path memory is not normal. In coma also, in brain death, and stroke affecting brain stem. Stroke affecting brain stem. They are also useful to assess autoacoustic emissions. They are useful to assess autoacoustic emissions. That is, and they assess artery threshold. How much level of loss is the artery threshold. Audiometer and all other things are also there for correct assessment. And to discriminate sensory from neural hearing loss. They can also discriminate sensory from neural hearing loss. Thank you. With this, we finish. About the potentials, auditory, and we have also seen visual evoked potentials. They may come as a short notes also, they can come. And therefore, we have to read up this. And some people have not written the written exams on Wednesday. It's very important, because on the times, if you keep on writing MCQs and the exams, you have to answer written also. It will be a sort of practice for you. Therefore, written exams are also very important. Whatever you write, you know you write, and it will be a sort of practice, because we don't know when they suppose suddenly they announce the exams, and you have to write written, and you have to recollect and write. You have to recollect what you have read, and you have to write. All the time, if I can see questions, they may not be, you may not read essay questions. Essay questions are equally important. MCQs, we not much MCQs are not given here. Present, we are giving only essay questions. Therefore, business can be conducted, and some 18 people have not attempted the exam. But it's only for your sake we are conducting the exam, since we are not able to directly come into contact with you, because we are conducting for this only. Otherwise, by this time, we would have conducted repeated exams, and we would have trained you properly. But because of this, we are doing all this online. Therefore, you should be alert, and you should attend the exam. Why 18 people have not attended, I don't understand. But with this, we have finished this entire about the potential. Now, this thank you.